Hey guys, this is Austin. The internet is obsessed with frame rates, but do they actually matter? Any video, this one included, is nothing more than a series of still frames that are played back quickly. So for this video, you should pick the 60 frames per second option. That way you can get the full effect of what I'm talking about. So this is 15 frames per second. As you can see, it looks a little choppy, a little weird. I mean, yeah, you can see that this is video, but it almost looks like some kind of like dream sequence. Now we're at 24 frames per second. Now this is past the point where your brain is looking at the individual stills and perceiving them as motion. So 24 frames is much more common in things like TV shows and especially movies. And now we're moving on to 30 frames per second. Now this is probably the most common for web content. It's pretty much what all of my videos are in. And here you'll see that motion is nice and smooth and it looks pretty natural. Now we're at 60 frames per second. Here you can see that motion is much more smooth, almost to the point where it's a little bit distracting. Now while 60 FPS video is not that common, you will see it a lot in things like gameplay. Things become even more noticeable the more motion there is. That's why, while 30 frames works for most things, switching to 60 can work better for fast-paced action like sports. Another big area where frame rate is important is for gaming. Not only do lower frame rates look distracting, but they can have a real effect on gameplay. It's one thing to watch a movie or TV show, and another when you're controlling something on screen. Low frame rates not only look choppy, but add a sense of lag to your gameplay. Most displays top out at 60 frames, however something like this Asus monitor can handle up to 144 frames per second when you hook it up to a gaming PC. With a 1 millisecond response time, in theory this should almost completely eliminate any sense of lag or choppiness, but how much of a difference does it actually make? To find out, I invited a few of my friends to sit down and play a game at a few different frame rates to see if they could actually tell the difference.
Why, oh Jesus, 10 FPS is bullshit.
If I'm flying, I wouldn't know it, because it feels like I'm just bumping along.
Yeah, it's super, it just feels, not even laggy, but it just feels slow.
Is this a sick joke? This sucks, Austin. Why are you making me play this?
Smooth is going to be the key word in this video. Can we get a smooth counter going?
It's, like, really jumpy. It's not smooth.
Like, it's playable in the sense that I can do things, but first off, this is just burning my eyes.
I don't want to play anymore.
Not a fan of 10 frames. All right, this is oh, that's so much better.
Oh my gosh, this is worlds different. This is so much smoother.
Whoa, this still sucks.
Like, it depends on the game you're playing too. I think some games you can pull off 30 and it's okay, but you can definitely notice in this one that it's not as smooth as it could be.
Yeah, you know what? Watching that thing move out there looks a lot more natural.
It's just a lot smoother.
This still looks like N64 right here.
Like, it's usable, but that's about the most you can say. It's not good.
All right, 60 frames. Okay, you can feel, yeah, when I start to move, it's a lot smoother when I move. Feels like Need for Speed.
Ah, oh, that's better.
A lot smoother than 30 was. Like, I mean, the jump to 10 to 30 was more noticeable because 10 is that painful. You can definitely tell looking at 30 versus 60.
It's really responsive and really fast, but I kind of want to puke.
60 is really good. It doesn't make me feel queasy or anything. That's a common complaint with people who don't play.
Yeah, I mean, this is just the standard right now for a reason.
I've never played at 144, so this is gonna be interesting. Oh my god. Oh my god, this is great.
So smooth, look at all the crumbling. So smooth.
Everything is coated in butter. Even though I'm flying, so that doesn't make any sense. There's no friction.
The murders of the chickens. I like 144, it's great.
I can tell that it's faster, but it still feels about the same as what 60 was.
Like, I feel like the difference between 30 and 60 was, you know, not as noticeable as 10 to 30, and then same for this. Like, it's smoother, but I don't think it's as drastic of a change, at least to my eyes.
I'm happy with 144. Austin, I'm glad that you have me participate in your video because I'm really enjoying it. Thank you everybody for watching. Subscribe to Austin Evans, and I'll see you guys later.
And
if you're doing some sort of reaction game, like a Need for Speed, or like a shooter or something, then you might be tempted to spend the extra and see things in what seems like hyperspeed.
So what do you guys think is the sweet spot for frame rates? Let me know in the comments below and I will catch you in the next one.